Hi guys, welcome back to another video. I decided it's time to talk about editing. I know I'm a little bit of a noob as of right now, but I've been doing a lot of research on how to make aesthetic looking videos, but I've only found videos related to an Apple computer, which I of course do not have. I've been using a Windows computer forever, and I love it, honestly. So I just wanted to find ways to make cute videos without the necessity of having Procreate or iMovie, which in the case of Windows computer, it's not available. So I'm going to share my tips with you. Before we start, I have a Lenovo IdeaPad Flex 4. I got it like 4 years ago, but it's still working perfectly fine and I love it, so I totally recommend it. Stage number one, softwares. If you're looking for a free software, I recommend Clipchamp. It's a really good software if you're just starting out. It's completely free. You can access it through Google. You can just search it up, or you can download the app version, which is the one that I use most of the time. You can do webcam recordings, screen recordings. You can add music from their audio library, and you can just import all videos from wherever you have them. You can also import videos through Bluetooth if you are using a phone. It also has a lot of fonts for texts, and it has cool effects and transitions. It's kind of limited on the effects and transitions, but I think it's really fine, and it's completely free. The only thing is that when you want to export a video, it will only allow you to export it in the lowest quality possible because you're not paying for the premium version, but regardless from that, it's perfectly fine. It's completely free. You can use all of the things that they have there. And this is what I started with, and I honestly loved it. But we're going now to my second option, which is Filmora X. Filmora X cost $39.99, and it has so many more possibilities and options. It has an audio library, you can add fun titles, it has a lot of transitions, multiple effects and elements. It's really good. I honestly really like it, and it's what's been working for me the best. But if you're not really seriously thinking about getting into YouTube that well, I don't recommend wasting $40 if you're not going to use it. So I recommend you start with Clipchamp, get used to the basic editing, and then you can upgrade into Filmora. The only thing that I do have to say about Filmora is that its color correction tool is very limited. I do minimum color correction, or I don't correct the clips at all. But regardless from that, it's amazing. Point number two. When it comes to YouTube, you're trying to build your personal brand, so you should match your aesthetic to the fonts that you're using. For this, I recommend you check out thatfont.com, which I will link down below. They have a ton of free fonts that you can just download and automatically install into your computer. To download the font, you just have to click on the download button and it will automatically download into your computer. And then you click the install button once you open the file, and it's ready to be used. Number three, if you're looking for copyright-free audios, I totally recommend you check out SoundCloud or Epidemic Sounds. They have copyright-free music that you can download. It's totally free, and you're not at risk of getting any virus into your computer. I also recommend that you Google the song on YouTube first before adding it to your video and see if it is licensed. And if it is, then you should totally not use it unless you don't want to get monetized. And number four, graphic art or design or whatever you want to call it. I know that it's quite hard to learn how to use a tool such as Photoshop, so I'm bringing to you a lifesaver that's called Canva. You have probably already heard of this graphic design app. I totally recommend it. It's what I use to create all of my channel artwork. I know it's for beginners, and I know there are things that it cannot do, but it's great, and it's all about just finding little tools to work with and make it amazing and beautiful and aesthetic. I use it for creating my intros, my outro, and to create those little doodle transitions in between clips, like that one. And I just totally recommend it. You can also do banners or thumbnails, and in general, all of the art that your YouTube channel requires. And it's very easy to navigate through. You don't have to have a lot of knowledge in graphic design. So it's totally a lifesaver for me. I truly hope this was helpful to you, because when I first started out, I was very confused, but this has totally worked for me. They are very basic tools and programs that you can use, and it's not that hard to learn how to use them, and their final result, I think it's quite pretty, so I totally recommend it, and I hope you liked it. I'll see you in my next video. Don't forget to subscribe. Bye bye. Point number two. That's a four.